Now, obviously, having more money does not necessarily mean that somebody is going to be a saver. There are a lot of people who earn very good salaries but have nothing in savings because they spend everything. However, people who earn a higher salary, they are in a position where it is easier for them to save money if they choose to do so. It is easier for them to build an emergency fund and also pay off debt. But just because you're not there yet does not mean you can't get there, and it doesn't mean that saving money is completely off the table. It might be harder to save, but with a few simple adjustments, you can free up cash that can help you build an emergency fund or just have more disposable cash throughout the month. The first tip to saving money on a low income is to budget. And yes, I know I might sound like Captain Obvious at the moment, but budgeting is so crucial to helping you have money left over at the end of the month. Everyone needs a budget, and it doesn't matter if you make $100,000 a year or $30,000 a year. Budgeting is crucial, but it is especially important if you have a low income because there's less room for error. It is a lot easier for someone at a higher income level to dig themselves out of a financial mistake. But if you are cash strapped and you don't have a lot of money to go around, you have to be very careful in how you manage your funds. I really like the 50-30-20 budget. And the reason why I like this approach is because if you commit to only spending 50% of your after-tax income on your needs, 30% on your wants, you will likely have money left over for savings and debt repayment. Now, if you calculate your income and your expenses and you find that your expenses are actually higher than your income, saving money will be a little harder, but it is still possible. The key is that you really will have to cut back or trim back some of your expenses, your variable and your fixed expenses, which we will get into. One way to trim back your variable expenses is to use the envelope method. This is an approach to budgeting that is by no means new. People have been using it for decades, and we used it when we first got married, and it works really well. Now, we didn't use it for all of our expenses. When it came to our housing, our utilities, our insurance, and other expenses that did not change from month to month, we would take that money and we kept it in the bank. Now, as far as our other expenses like fuel, personal expenses, transportation, and entertainment, we had different envelopes for different categories. And at the beginning of every month, we decided a reasonable amount to spend in each of these categories. And we went to the bank, we got the cash, and we would put the cash in the envelopes. And the reason why I love this approach, especially if you're on a lower income and you're trying to save money, is that it really forces you to be disciplined, because the whole idea is that you only spend the cash that's in the envelopes and you don't spend anything more. So once the cash is gone, it's gone, and you cannot spend any more in these categories until you refill your envelopes. If you stick to this system, it is very hard to overspend. And if you can curb overspending, you may have a lot more disposable cash that will allow you to build your savings account. Another tip to help you save money on a low income is to cut back your biggest expense. And for a lot of people, this will be housing. Now, if you don't earn a lot of money, chances are you're not spending a whole lot of money on housing. But even so, there might be room to cut back. And the reason why you want to tackle your biggest expense, which will likely be housing, is because a lot of people live above their means. And if you are spending too much on housing, that is really going to take away a lot of your options and is going to make it difficult to save money. And there are different ways to approach this. If you currently rent, you can look into finding a cheaper place to live once your lease expires. You can also look into getting a roommate or maybe renting a room, or you might even consider moving back home with your parents. On the other hand, if you are a homeowner, you can also run the numbers to see if it will be cheaper for you to sell or maybe buy or rent a cheaper place. You can also move to a cheaper part of town, and you can even talk with your mortgage lender or another lender to see if you can refinance your mortgage, because if you are able to get a lower interest rate, that can also lower your monthly payment, which will free up more money that you're able to save. Keep in mind though that your largest expense might not even be your house payment. It could be your car payment, or you might live in an area where cheaper rent or a cheaper mortgage really isn't going to happen. And if that's the case, really consider your transportation, because if you are able to sell your car, get into something a little cheaper, that can also free up money that will help you save. Another tip is to watch food spending. Now, of course, food is a necessity. We have to eat. However, food is also a variable expense that can get out of hand really quick if we're not careful. Food can quickly kill a budget, and this can happen whether you're eating out or you're preparing your own food, because a lot of times we go to the grocery store, we have in mind how much we want to spend, but then we get to checkout and we end up spending $10, $15, or $20 over our budget. If you want to save money every month and put more into your savings account, one thing you can do is to commit to trimming $20 to $25 off your grocery bill every single week. And by doing so, you can have an extra $80 to $100 a month, which you can put into savings. And there are a lot of simple ways to do this. The hard part is actually doing it, but you can shop with a list, you can shop alone, you can buy generic, and it even helps to not shop when you are hungry, because if you go into the store and you're hungry, everything looks good. And next thing you know, you're putting all this stuff into your cart that you don't need. It also helps to eat out less, because the cost can add up so quickly, and sometimes you may not even realize how much you're spending on food outside the house until you go back and you look at your statements. For me, I noticed that on those weeks where we tend to eat out a little bit more than usual, there are usually two common denominators. It was either a week when I was super busy and did not have time, or it was a week when I didn't feel well. And if you find that you also tend to eat out more under these circumstances, one thing you can do is really meal prep your lunches for the week on Sunday. And this really works, because in the mornings, a lot of times we're running around, we're running behind schedule, and we're just trying to get out the door. And you might feel, okay, I don't have time to worry about lunch, I'll just grab something out. And you know, occasionally it may not be a big deal, but if you get into the habit of doing this 2, 3, or 4 times a week, the cost, it really does add up. But with everything already in containers and separated, all you have to do is run in the kitchen, grab it, and you're out the door. Of course, you have to remember it. So one thing you can also do is maybe put like a little post-it note on your front door which says, grab your lunch. That way you have it and you don't have to spend money. And another thing you can also do is maybe spend a couple of hours on Saturday or Sunday and preparing most of your weekly meals in advance for dinner. And you can even use crock pots more, because if you come home from work and you're tired and the last thing you want to do is cook, more than likely you're going to order out. But if the food is there, it's ready, you can eat and you can save money. Another tip is to save your 5th week paycheck. Out of every year, there are 4 or 5 months that will have a 5th week. And if you get paid weekly, that means that you will get about 4 or 5 extra paychecks throughout the year, which really comes in handy when you're trying to save money. Now, people do different things with this money. Some will have a good time with it, others will use it to pay off debt. And debt repayment, you know, that is a great goal. However, if you do not have anything in savings, one thing I recommend is using those extra checks to first build yourself a $1,000 emergency fund. And this is just a starter emergency fund. And once you have your starter emergency fund, you can then use those extra checks to pay off debt. And once the debt is gone, then use that money to start building a 3 to 6 month emergency fund. Another tip is to boost your skills online and then use these skills to freelance. And the reason I included this tip is because some people who have a lower income, they are really committed and they're really determined to really get their savings account to a point where it needs to be fast. And to do that, a lot of times you will have to increase your income. But sometimes increasing your income will involve increasing your skills, which take time and money. So one thing I recommend is maybe taking advantage of some online courses or classes that you can do that are really inexpensive. That way you can learn something and then you can take those skills and maybe start freelancing and start a side hustle. If you do a simple online search for online classes, a lot of options will come up. Some of these options might be free, others you may have to pay for. And just to give you an example, there's Skillshare, there's Udemy. I actually did a digital marketing class with Udemy, I think about a year ago, and I can't really remember how much I paid, but it was either $9.99 or $19.99. I can't really remember, but I got it on sale. And it was a simple, basic course on digital marketing, but I learned a lot from that program, and I was able to take the skills that I learned and use it in my own business. I was able to use it with my blog, and I was actually able to use some of those tips to help me grow this YouTube channel. So online courses, they are useful, and once you learn a skill, you can then market your services to others, which will allow you to earn additional income, which can help you save more money. The reason why I said you can take the skills you learn online and turn it into a side hustle is because even if you learn a lot from an online course, some employers may require someone with more experience. So if you freelance, you build your portfolio, there might be an opportunity down the road to take that skill and actually transition it into a job. Or if your freelance business starts to take off, there's an opportunity to be your own boss. Another tip is to learn how to negotiate. Negotiating is a lost art, but it's something that more people should definitely embrace. Of course, you can't negotiate everything. Some things are non-negotiable, but there are a lot of things that you can negotiate to help you save money on a monthly basis. And just to give you a few suggestions, you can negotiate cable, you can negotiate your rent, your utilities, your insurance. There are a lot of things that you can get for a lot less just by opening your mouth and asking for a discount. If you're able to get your insurance company or your utility company to reduce your rate by a small amount, it may seem really minor and insignificant, but those savings will add up over time. And just to illustrate, if you're able to get 5 of your regular monthly services discounted by like $10 a month, that's a $50 savings every single month, which is $600 a year. Another tip to help you save money on a low income is to do a money challenge. Now, there are different types of money challenges, and to be honest, some will be easier to accomplish if you have a little bit more money, but there are several options for people who are working with a small budget. Now, I recently did a video about several money challenges that are really easy and that actually work, so I'm not gonna dive too much into this topic in this video. However, just to give you an example of some things you can do on a lower income, you can do the dollar challenge, you can do the penny challenge, you can do the pantry challenge. I mean, there are just so many options. You can even get creative and come up with your own challenge based on your circumstances. Sometimes you have to get creative and think outside the box, and I really love a good money challenge because it turns saving money into a game, and when you're having fun, it becomes so much easier to save your first $500 to $1,000. So there you have it. Those are my tips to help you save money on a low income. And I really hope that you guys found this video to be helpful. And if you did, please give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, do consider subscribing. On this channel, we talk a lot about different money topics and different ways that you can fix your wallet. So if you like videos like this, I do post every weekend and sometimes during the week. So thank you again for watching, and I'll see you in a few days.